I'm Tammy Kolda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. On this YouTube channel, I'm providing a detailed how-to guide on using TIXI and PGFPLOTS. These videos are based on my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, as well as some bonus materials. Today's demonstration is on making scatter plots using PGFPLOTS. PGFPLOTS is a LaTeX package that enables you to embed graphics right inside your LaTeX document. I'll start with creating some basic scatter plots, then I'll show how to put different sets of data into the same plot. These can be different columns in the same file or different files altogether. It can also be data points that are differentiated by a so-called meta value, indicating different classes or types. This is one of a series of videos on TIXI and PGFPLOTS, so please check out the other videos on this channel to learn more. I've already created a starting point for us with a document preamble. The main requirement is the package PGFPLOTS. The other packages are just conveniences. Here, parskip and full page are just to make things look nice. The hyperref package is so that I can link the author name back to the YouTube channel, as you see over here. After the title, I do some initial setup using PGFPLOTS set. Since this is at the very top of the LaTeX document, it will apply to every graphic in the document. I discuss recommended defaults for PGFPLOTS in my Getting Started with PGFPLOTS video. Here I'm just going to use some options essential for today's video, and I'm not going to go into a lot of details. The compat flag specifies the version of PGFPLOTS to conform with. The scale only axis key tells it that I'm specifying the actual width and height. I go on to set all the graphics to be 6 centimeters wide by 5 centimeters tall. For the figure titles, I'm changing how far the title is above the top of the figure from the default of 6-point to 3-point. And I'm changing the title font to be large and boldface. Today we're creating scatter plots. A scatter plot puts points on the XY plane. This differs from a line plot in that the points are not connected. So let me paste a basic plot here. The TIXI picture environment is the drawing canvas. The axis environment creates axes for the plots. And then the add plot command reads information from the file data.txt, where the columns contain data to be used for our points. By default, the first column is used for the X values, and the second column is used for the Y values. Here we're just specifying the color and that the mark is the default star. Let's see what happens when we compile it. By default, we get a line plot. So in order to make this a scatter plot, we have to change things. To make this a scatter plot, we merely have to add the plot option only marks. So I'll add that here. And now when we recompile it, we see that we have only the marks and not the line that attaches them. This can also go inside the axis options, in which case it will impact every add plot command. There are a lot of different marks you can use. An asterisk creates a filled circle, and that's actually the default. You can get an open circle by changing mark equals star to mark equals O, as we see over to the right. Let's do another scatter plot with a title and axis labels. I'm using the iris dataset, which is well known in machine learning and comprises measurements from 150 iris plants of 3 types. I'm showing a picture of the 3 different types below. We'll be plotting the petal length versus the sepal length, as you see here. I have links for the picture and data sources in the show notes. One important note is that this dataset is comma separated. By default, PGFPLOTS expects column tables to be separated by spaces, so we had to tell it that the separator is instead a comma, which we do with an option to the table that is call sep equals comma. We will plot the petal length versus the sepal length, so I've chosen those as the X and Y columns to be plotted. Since I didn't specify the mark, it was a filled circle by default. I can instead change the mark, so here I'll change it to an actual asterisk. So we use asterisk to be a filled circle. If you want an actual asterisk, you spell it out as a name in the plot option, and then we get an asterisk as you see here. We'll also go ahead and add a title and axis labels to this. These are options that we put at the axis level. So here I've specified that the title is iris data and the X label and Y label are given appropriately. Next, let's plot different columns from the same data file. We'll revisit our plot from the file data.txt. So here I have the same plot as before, except for I changed the mark to an asterisk. So after that's done compiling, we'll show that here. Now we can plot another column from the same data file. So remember that this is plotting column A as the Y values by default, and the IDs are the X values by default, because it's always the first and second column correspond to X and Y. We want to use a different set of Y values. We can specify a different choice for y. So in this new add plot command, I'm specifying y equals b. I'm also changing the color and the mark. When I recompile that, then I see that I have both sets of values plotted in different ways. We also want to add a legend so that we can remember which mark corresponds to which column. That's an axis option. The legend should be in the order that the add plot commands were added. So this first one plots column A and the second one plots column B, and I put the legend entries in the same order. Another use for scatter plots is plotting data from different files. I've split the iris data into three files, one per iris type. Let's work on plotting that. For the axis options here, I have put the title, the X label, and the Y label as before. And now I'm doing something sort of tricky. Rather than repeating the table options over and over again, I'm going to put them up here in the axis option, and I preceded it with table slash. That lets it know it's a table option. So I'm setting the columns separator to be a comma and the same X and Y columns in every file. And then I'm specifying only mark, so I don't have to specify that for every add plot. I'm also going ahead and specifying that all the lines should be drawn as thick. So I just have one data file here, the Setosa data file. And so I'm drawing that as olive triangles. I'm also slightly changing the mark size from the default of 2 points up to 3 points so that it matches a little better the others. You'll see when we get to adding the extra files. So now we're going to add a plot for the VersaColor iris type. We're going to make that cyan squares. Notice that it also changed the X and Y range to accommodate these additional values. Finally, we're going to add the plot for the Virginica data, which we're going to plot as orange circles. Again, we can add a legend to keep things straight. So we'll go ahead and set the legend position to be northwest, where we have a gap, and then we'll specify the legend entries. Again, we put these in the order of our add plot. So first Setosa, then VersaColor, then Virginica. In the last example, I'd separated the data into three files, but what if that wasn't possible or easy to do? What if it came all in one file with a column indicating the class? That's the thing that we'll look at in this last example. In this case, we have all the iris data in one file, and there's a column indicating the type of each iris. So here's the plotting commands. Let me go ahead and compile that, show you what it looks like, and then I'll explain what we did to make this work. So one thing that's different is we add these two options to the axis. Scatter and scatter source equals explicit symbolic. So the explicit symbolic tells it that we're going to give a set of actual classes that are represented by symbols, in this case, words. Notice that I also have only marks. You'll need that somewhere in your option as well. And then when I do the add plot command, I'm reading the file iris.data, and it has a column named class. And that's going to be my meta. So I'm going to use that column for my meta information. In that column are the symbolic types, Setosa, VersaColor, and Virginica. And then inside the add plot command, I specify scatter slash classes equals, and then how each class should be plotted. So I say Setosa is olive triangles, the VersaColor is cyan squares, and the Virginica is orange circles. These are separated by commas, but there should not be a comma following the last class definition. Normally, PGFPLOTS and TIXIE are pretty loose about extra commas. I have one up here. It's not a problem. But in this case, if you have an extra comma here, it will get very confused. So you have to have that the final class has no comma following it. So now you know how to handle multiple classes all mixed together in the same file. I hope you enjoyed today's video. You should now know how to create scatter plots in PGFPLOTS. There's a link to the Overleaf document we created today in the show notes. Please click like or subscribe if you want more videos like this. You can also buy my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, at your favorite book retailer. Thanks for watching.